Welcome back at Play-X-Play, the show where we're going to analyze 3x3 highlights and lowlights with the pro players. I have Dejan Majstorovic, the maestro himself, a legend.
A legend, thank you very much.
How are you doing?
Very good, yeah. We are here like for 5-6 days and I feel very happy in Amsterdam, always.
Yeah, it's what Amsterdam does with
we
people.
We just don't have a lot of luck in Amsterdam when we play tournaments, but okay, like this, it's okay.
How did you start playing basketball?
Because of my friends from class, all of them almost play basketball and they're like, come on, you are told you can be good in basketball, and in 14 years old, I start playing basketball. From beginning, I always love to play 3x3 actually, like when I don't have practice in 5-on-5, I'm on the court for 3x3.
Outside?
And, yeah, outside, of course. In Serbia, we have that rule that when you win, you stay on the court. So if come 5-6 teams, you lose, you can go home.
Yeah. Why is 3x3 a better sport for you than 5x5?
You know, coach tell you what to do. And in basket, in 3x3, you can do whatever you want. You can do, your imagination came to forward, like you can...
More creative,
yes. So I feel more, how to say, free.
Yeah.
On the basketball 3x3 court than on 5-on-5. I just have a little problem with my teammates because we don't have coach to tell me to stop shooting, and I shooting all the time, and sometimes they're pissed off, but
yeah. As long as you hit them, it's no problem. Right?
Yeah, but sometimes happening that I don't hit any three, and then they start yelling on me like stop.
Yeah.
Be a little bit more, how you say, passion. Wait, you're gonna shoot, just wait. And I cannot wait. I just take the ball, go out of the 2 points and shoot.
Well, we have sometimes players like that I play very low level 5x5. And when we have a player like that, we always call him the wormhole, because if you pass the ball just disappears.
Yeah.
Gone.
It's the same thing. They're waiting for the ball and I just, I call them rebound. Come on guys, rebound.
Yeah, and pass the ball back. We're going to watch some highlights and one low light. But I'm very curious about how you look at the game, how you look at situations. This is a game in 2015. It's a World Tour semifinal against
Trebovje.
Trebovje.
They call themselves now Piran.
With only 5 seconds to go, you're 2 points behind. And I think you get the ball. Well, we already know what you're going to do because you told us. And there you go.
Dušan play 1-on-1 and I expected him to shoot some step back, mm-hmm. what he doing all the time. And then he drive in my head was, where he going?
Yeah, because you cannot have a one-pointer.
I don't know why Finjgar and Ovnik help. Actually, Finjgar help. But they play their kind of defense the whole game with some helping. And they don't need to help. This is 5 seconds until end. If they just play face-to-face defense, it's over probably. I stay alone, the 3-point ball goes in and we was very happy.
Yeah, it's amazing that because here is Dušan going for 1 point and three guys playing defense.
And I'm alone like 5 meters.
Yeah.
Like, that's 3x3 basketball. 1 second without concentration, you can lose the game.
I like the way, because I do this even when my teammates shoot. You try to
in English, to ball.
Yeah, you try
to
steer
the ball to the basket.
Do you also do it when you play race games? And you do the corner, do you?
Actually, I play only football
on
the PlayStation, but sometimes when I shoot, the ball always,
It's just the desire for that ball to go in. So you are a two-point specialist. Or do you think you're a two-point specialist, but other people don't think so?
I think the other people think, but I'm just kidding. Yeah, I think I'm the two-point specialist, but last 2 years I'm not happy the way I play, and I'm not happy the way I shoot, but now I do that much better.
Yeah.
Is it mentally that your shot is off, or is it technique?
I think it's mentally. I know when I have confidence and that, I'm gonna score 5-6 2 points, but sometimes when you don't have confidence, it's difficult. So I think it's a lot of mentally, and you just need to have confidence in that kind of moment to score that kind of shots. It was amazing when we score. It's like overtime, and I need to say like we was on the bench talk about what we're gonna do in overtime. Dušan say like I'm gonna get the ball and I'm gonna score 2 points, and we say okay. Fischer gave him the ball and he scored 2 points, we won.
He has no problem with confidence.
Never. Never problems with confidence.
We're going to go to India in 2018.
Against Riga.
Against Riga, another rival, I think.
Yes, we're losing that game like 15-6, 15-7. Oh, Dušan was so pissed off when he missed this.
Yeah.
Actually, I play very good defense because I stole like three balls of that five games, of that five offenses.
Yeah, because that's what people forget, right? Also now we're watching the highlights, but it's not the highlights. It's all the stuff that happens before that.
Yes, I know like everything what's happened, and I miss like two, three times for 2 points. I shoot very bad. I know Dušan, like, please stop, wait. Because I know he always in that moment looking at me to give me the ball to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
I know if he cannot shoot, he tried to find me to shoot the ball in the end.
Yeah. And here you have to play another defense. There you go, good steal. This is good anticipation, right? Because they only have 1 point. They need only 1 point. Yeah. It's a dangerous pass.
Because of that, I move from the traverse.
Yeah.
Because I know what they're going to do, of course. And I think next offense of Riga or the before that, I block Lasmanis, and I never block in my life, you know. That's like just motivation and desire for win.
Yeah. And all this all happens while you're tired because, you know, intensive games, etc. It's very good defense because you anticipate very well, but it's also risky because if you don't have this ball, it's gone, right?
Yes, it's gone, but I don't know what to say. I feel that I need to go on that ball, and it doesn't matter what's happening. We need to get that ball. So if Lasmanis catches the ball, it's basket for sure, and we lose the game.
Yeah. A little bit of pushing.
And this was very stupid from Lasmanis to help. They want to kill him. His team, why? Let him to score one, and you have another offense for win. And watch, they yell on Lasmanis, all of them.
Yeah. Kicking the ball. They're pretty angry. And he knows as well. You can see he knows. And again, and we come back to what we've talked about before. Is just, you know, you get a lot of space. When you get it in your pocket, you know.
I need to make it. If I'm shooter, if I'm alone, I need to make it. It doesn't matter, is it first minute or the last minute.
Is that something that goes in your head at this moment? Do you think, oh man, it's the game winner, I have to shoot it? Or is it the same as every other shot?
I remember in this moment, I didn't think about anything. I just want, I always in that moment running, like, give me the ball, I want to shoot. It was like 2-3 minutes without stopping.
Mm-hmm.
Defense, offense.
So
you're
really
just
quick.
Focused to win. Yeah. I have a lot of confidence actually in that moment because I play three good defense. The last three defense I play very good. That was the way I get of confidence, of course.
So, and again, it's the defense that brings you in this situation, you know.
Yeah, you need to do some good things on the court to get the confidence.
Let's go to a shot that's done by another guy where you, and this one is probably gonna hurt. I think this is for third place.
Yes,
in Amsterdam.
In Amsterdam.
Right here.
We don't like to play here tournaments.
You like to be here on holiday, but not on.
On holiday, yes, but tournaments we are not very happy.
And Michael Hicks has the ball, a very good player. Only 7 seconds to go. You're 1 point ahead, so you only need a stop.
But this is an amazing shot.
Falling.
We expect him to shoot immediately because of that savage jump, and he did a crazy thing. We play very bad, like. I don't know, are we was disappointed by losing in the semi-final against Latvia.
Mm-hmm.
We started talking like, come on guys, it's a game for the third place, we need to win this. But still probably some that very bad feeling because we want to play the final, and they leading all the whole game, and on the end they make some stupid fouls, and Savic made the two free throws, and we like leading. Mm-hmm. I didn't believe that we're leading on that game like in one moment. And I like, yeah, this is good, we're gonna win the bronze, but Mike made the crazy shot and they deserve to win, probably.
It's not the shot, it's the whole process of the game.
Yes.
And how are you coping with losing games? How are you, right after it, you're angry at yourself, at your teammate, at the referee?
Amsterdam? Referee always is always referee fault. But
yeah, of course, yeah.
No, I'm very difficult when I lose, like, a couple days I cannot talk normally and...
Mm-hmm.
I think all the time about what I can do better, why I do this, why I didn't do that, why I didn't be concentrated, why somebody scored on me. But that's sports. Because of that, we love to watch sports because it's a lot of interesting games. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Yeah. So.
And again, Michael makes an amazing
shot. Amazing shots, yeah. And he told me after the game, like, yeah, that's for the last year.
Yeah. But we're going to watch that one. Because you had a history with Poland because the year before, you played here in...
semi-final in Philippines World Cup.
Yeah, Manila. Philippines is a basketball crazy country, right?
Yeah, very.
Here it's 19-19, 1 minute to go, but you know, 2 points is a game winner.
I feel like I can shoot the 2 seconds until end, and I believe I can score, so everything other is history.
Yeah. But this is a quick shot.
Yeah, it was a quick shot because he's a big Pavlovsky, and I need to shoot quickly.
Did you already know you were going to go left? Is that your favorite side?
Or? Yes, it's my favorite. Now I'm working on another side to go
of
to
course.
Shoot.
Yeah, yes. Of course. We're not going to give away strategic.
I'm shooting much faster from this. Yeah.
Yeah.
From the left.
Did you call class?
No, I didn't call. A little luck.
Do you have to change the trajectory of the ball?
Yes. When you alone, you shoot a little bit like this, but my shot is more.
Is already.
Yeah, it's already. Yeah. And I trying on the practicing to shoot like this. Yes. And I practice this kind of situation with coaches. They stay there like 3-2-1 and you have one dribbling and shoot for win. So
yeah, you've been there. Again, it's not the highlight. It's the whole process, training, working out to the highlight. And it's an amazing shot. And then he got back at you the year after. This is a game in 2014
against Romania. Yeah.
Against Romania, I think one of the better teams in 2014.
For sure.
Yeah, and we see a move here that you don't see a lot in basketball. This move, because I know the move as a sham god, of course, because I'm American oriented. Then preparing for this show today, I saw that YouTube called this the Bodiroga. So I was Googling Bodiroga, and I spent like half an hour just...
Amazing, yeah. Amazing. He was my idol, he and Peja Stojaković. In my street, we have one basket. I was there every day, all day alone, and I was trying to do this like Bodiroga. I'm not a good handler. Mm-hmm. I don't know to dribble the ball very well, because when
That's
I dribble the
should.
Ball, when I... Between the legs, probably ball always get on my leg and go out. So I'm not a good dribbler, but I really do this every day. And this is my first tournament with Savic, Dušan and Ždero. Mm-hmm. It was overtime. In overtime was 1-1. And we have a timeout. And I asked them, can I get the ball? They give me the ball. When I finish this, they told me they know what I'm going to do. Because I do this a lot in the Serbian tournaments when I play against them. Nobody expected from me to do this.
Right.
And nobody know me before this tournament. So I have feel this is going to be the basket, and it was good, yeah.
And it's a difficult move because...
It's good because this guy is never close.
Right, and you have some space.
Because of that, I play this play. Because he gave me the space. He know I need 1 point, so he maybe let me a little bit to shoot for 2 point. So I have the space to do that, do the Bodiroga move.
Yeah, and then you just twist him around.
I a little bit catch his arm. I'm good in that. Not in dribbling, but in catching, yeah, I'm good. And huddle.
Yeah, you keep him off, let's just say.
Yeah, I grab him for the hands to...
No, it's just a swimming move. You just...
Yeah. He grabbed me, so...
Yeah, you need
I
to
need to
loose.
Move his hand from my body.
Yeah, and he grabs you because he knows he's gone.
Yeah.
Have you done this move again later?
No. I play some tournament in Slovenia against Piran.
Yeah.
And I never play against them in that moment. And I do this against Ovnik. And Ovnik is very smart. He know I'm going to do that. He steal the ball and he tell me, like, where are you going? And in that moment, I was so pissed off. I like, okay, I see you. I'm waiting for you when we play Novi Sad and Trbovlje.
So you retired that, the move.
Yeah, I stopped playing.
Yeah.
So then Dušan started playing.
Dušan
played that much better between the legs. And.
But it's nice. It's a very nice move. And I like the unexpected part of, you know, it's how you surprise people, how you win games.
Yeah.
And also a very nice tribute to Bodiroga, which I can really recommend checking Bodiroga highlights.
How Bodiroga teach Carmelo Anthony.
Yeah. I think he does the same move, right?
The same move, and he did the between the legs, behind the back, and
yeah,
Carmelo go to sit on the
Carmelo was off to the dressing room.
Audience.
I want to thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And your knowledge, and it's amazing to be able to talk to a legend of the game and learn from him. And I know even when opponents are watching this and they say, so those are his weaknesses, it doesn't matter. Because when you get the ball, you shoot.
Because we work on our weaknesses.
Exactly. So thank you very much for being here.
Thank you very much for calling.
And thank you for watching this. And of course, we will be back with another great 3x3 player and talking about his or her highlights and lowlights. Thank you for watching.